Here, let us talk about the anatomy of the cephalic vein. The cephalic vein begins as the continuation of the lateral end of the dorsal venous arch. So once the cephalic vein is formed from the lateral end of the dorsal venous arch, it crosses the roof of the anatomical snuffbox, where it ascends along the radial border of the forearm and continues upwards in front of the elbow along the lateral border of the biceps, finally pierces the deep fascia exactly at the lower border of the pectoralis major and runs in the cleft between the pectoralis major as well as deltoid called as the deltopectoral groove up to the infraclavicular fossa. So at the infraclavicular fossa, it pierces the clavipectoral fascia and drains into the first part of the axillary vein to form the subclavian vein. So this is what is about the anatomy of the cephalic vein. Now let us talk about important points related to the cephalic vein. At the elbow, greater amount of the blood from the cephalic vein is shunted to the basilic vein through median cubital vein. And cephalic vein is accompanied by lateral cutaneous nerve of the forearm. And cephalic vein is a preaxial vein of the upper limb and corresponds to the great saphenous vein of the lower limb. So this is what is about the anatomy of the cephalic vein.